Welcome back, Earthlings. Today we're going to go over Intro to Geometry Step 2, the two techniques to solve any geometry, math, or other life problem. I know that sounds like a little bit of an overstatement, but I'm going to apply it mainly to geometry, but this will work for anything. All right. So this is not going to be rocket science, but you'd be surprised how helpful this can be. So here are the two ideas, top down or bottom up. So you see some sort of math problem. Now, I'm not going to give you guys a math problem in this video because we haven't gone into a lot of geometry yet. But you'll see us use these two techniques constantly in the future geometry videos, so stay tuned for those. So here's the idea. If you have some sort of intricate geometry problem, your first approach is the top down. In other words, what you want to do is figure out what you want to find. So let's say you want to find the radius of a circle and you're given its area. So the top-down approach basically says, let's see where we want to get to. So we want to find the radius and we're starting at the bottom so we know the area. We have some information. So rather than try to work forwards, we think, well, to get the radius, what would we need? Oh, we might need the area formula. Okay, so I can use that with, so the idea is basically you have information in the problem, but then they ask a question. So we're going to start with the question and work our way backwards. So you could think of this as backwards instead of top down. I prefer thinking of top down because I think of this, the key word that I think of this for this is strategy. So we're going to visualize our strategy first. So probably the most important word here is strategy. So don't just start number crunching and doing a ton of stuff. Think, what would I need to find this? Well, I would need that. What would I need to find this part? I would need these two. What would I need to find these two? I'd need these four. To find that, I'd need these two. And so that tells you to start over here because then you could work your way there. All right. That's the top down one. The bottom up is the reverse. So you're going to start with a great label diagram. And you're just going to start figuring out useful intermediate results. So that just can be literally anything. For example, let's say you have a triangle, you know one angle, you know a second angle. So you figure out a third angle and see if that helps you find something else. Now, in general, for almost any, not any, let's say 90% of school purposes, I'm going to recommend the top-down strategy. Most people, when they don't really know what they're doing, kind of do some thing in the middle or a bottom-up strategy. I've noticed with students that have a lot of difficulty. So what you want to do is not just start doing whatever, but focus what's my strategy to get me there and work backwards from there. So you're going to visualize the strategy first. Now, in order to do that, you may not even understand the problem. So you may first need to know what the actual problem, like what's the challenge? Why is this so difficult? Like, oh, it's kind of hard to find this because this is not given to me. So that tells you, oh, I must find that unknown quantity. That's the central aspect of the problem. To do that, you may just want to play around with the problem. So it could be a problem where you're looking for a pattern, or maybe you're writing an essay. It might not be geometry. You're writing an essay and you have no idea where to start. So you might just start brainstorming ideas. Now, actually, notice I've written play for both. So the brainstorming ideas might be this bottom-up approach where you just start seeing what bubbles up, or like the free writing on my channel that I have. So the idea is these are two strategies available. If you're stuck, ask yourself, are you only using one of these? Have you considered the other one? If you're just doing this, maybe consider the other one. Now, so let me make another point. So you want to make a great label diagram. This is a small point. When I put great in quotes because a great diagram is a little subjective, by the way. Hopefully you've watched the previous video where I talk about how you make a good diagram. But it's also a bit of an art and it depends on the problem. So I didn't mention that in the last video, but I should have. So there's no one standard great diagram. It's whatever is useful to you. And depending on the question asked, a good diagram might vary because you might want it for different purposes. All right. So provided you have a great diagram, typically the bottom-up approach is you start labeling and figuring out these intermediate results. So you're starting here and you're bubbling your way up till you get there. The problem with the bottom-up strategy is unless you have a full game plan, the full strategy, you may not know where you're heading. So maybe instead of going this way, there could be some other branch that goes off all the way there or there. So this is often slower and you get confused, like, what's my next step? I'm not sure what to do. Whereas this takes a few seconds where you're doing very little work or calculation, but this is the creative part. Once you figure this out, it's just mechanical. Then you just do number crunching, largely number crunching. So at least for this level. So typically in school problems and standardized tests, like the SAT, whatever the tests are in your country, doesn't matter. You're gonna see pretty short or pretty easy to medium questions. Medium could be difficulty or medium size. You're typically not gonna see some mega math proof or something really hard. And for those, I think a lot of times you're gonna improve and save a lot of time and get the hard questions right if you first visualize the strategy. Now, for the bottom up ones, when should you use this? Typically, if you have no idea what to do, or if it's a really long and hard problem, you may just wanna start doing something and maybe that will trigger an idea. But like I said, for the shorter and medium problems, this is not such a great approach. But notice, again, the theme for both of them, you want to play around with the problem. So you may have no idea what to do, but you start, maybe you played around with it a little bit and that triggered, oh, this will be the top-down strategy. So I'll leave it at that. Try this on anything. Try this on a math problem, on a life problem. So on a life, why would this be applicable to life? So you may, let's say, have a goal like weight loss, or I want to get stronger. So that's your top level goal. Like, you want to be super strong and you're currently not super strong. You could try work backward. Like, in order to get strong, what would I have to do? Well, I would have to lift heavier weights. I would have to sleep more, I have to eat more, whatever. Or if maybe you don't have a goal, you can just say, hey, I'm unhappy with my life. I want to make a change. So the bottom up approach would be, you just start trying several different things. If you normally do something, you change it up to something else. You try a new activity. And then you stumble upon something like, hey, I like this. I feel better when I do this thing. So you didn't know what that thing was going to be, so you're just exploring and playing around. So, and maybe if you're just kind of always just doing things randomly and improvising, maybe you want to go the other way and try to plan things out more. So that's why, see where you fall. Are you a top-down sort of leading person or bottom-up? I tend to be more top-down, but they can both be useful. So here's sort of the holy grail. Eventually, you want to know when to do this approach, when to do this approach, and when to link them up. So they're not mutually exclusive. You could go a little bit backwards, a little bit forwards, and I made this dot a little larger. You could meet in the middle, right? So you could see there's some triangle. I have to find its area, but if I knew the base and the height, then I could find it, but that's a little hard, so I have to do a little work to get there. So think about linking them up, but you know, maybe I would say sort of 90%, 80% of the time, a lot of the time, you probably want to lean more towards the top down for school purposes. All right, and I'm gonna leave you guys with a quote by the legendary pianist Bill Evans, and it's sort of gonna apply to linking these top down, bottom up stuff, and it's kind of like the top down strategy. So his quote is, intuition should lead knowledge, but it can't be out there on its own. If it's out there on its own, you're going to flounder sooner or later. So what does that mean? Well, in this context, this is kind of intuitive, right? We have an intuition of how to solve the problem. We come up with a strategy, but it actually ties into yet another thing, which is to do this, we have to have solid skills to do either of these. So if your skills aren't mastered and solid, you can't visualize the strategy. So we're gonna cover similar triangles, the Pythagorean theorem, all sorts of stuff. So let's say you're not good at the Pythagorean theorem, or you don't even know the Pythagorean theorem, then you're gonna have a tough time visualizing a strategy that involves the Pythagorean theorem. So you might have an intuition, but like I said, your skills have to be in place. And go back to that Bill Evans quote, right? So you may wanna do a little bit of work here, both in terms of skill mastery, but also the bottom-up approach, maybe play around with it a little bit and link them up. It's a bit of an art, but hopefully you guys have an idea. So next time you have a problem, don't just randomly jump into one of these approaches or a middle approach. Think, what would be best for this problem? You know, for this math problem, this geometry, this English essay, this reading comprehension, your life issue, you know, your boyfriend or girlfriend left you, whatever it is, doesn't matter. Think which of these approaches or a middle approach is more appropriate. All right, hopefully that was helpful. I will see you guys in the next video.